A northern Kentucky neighborhood surrounded by officers. Suspects barricade themselves inside a home. We're live with the SWAT standoff. Plus,
they actually dragged them down and ate them up.
A local pet owner devastated tonight after her little dog is killed by two pit bulls that got loose from their yard. And
it's not even safe to come out and go to the grocery store at night. You got to do everything in the daytime. It's not safe.
Local neighbors are outraged after a three-year-old girl is in critical condition. She was shot.
Leading the way, on air, online, and on the go. WLWT News 5 at 11 starts now.
We begin with some breaking news tonight. An entire northern Kentucky neighborhood on lockdown. Officers from several agencies rushed to the scene. Good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello.
And I'm Mike Dardis, and this is happening in Independence. WLWT News 5's Jackie Canjado is live now as this thing is just ending. What is going on out there, Jackie?
And Mike and Cherie, it's been a busy night out here for a whole host of police and drug enforcement agencies. The good news right now, about a half hour ago, agencies, officers were able to get this man in custody peacefully. So the shelter in place order that was in place for some of the surrounding neighbors has since been lifted. That's the important news tonight. But we want to give you an idea for how all of this started. We want to show you some video that we shot shortly after we arrived on the scene. Now, police tell us this call came in around 8 o'clock. So police have been dealing with this man for the better part of the last 2.5 hours. The call came in. He apparently, according to police, was working in this home. Neighbors tell us that the home had recently been in foreclosure, that someone had bought it, and that they were doing some renovating, some work. So this was a contractor, from what we understand from police, who was working inside the home. Some of his co-workers called police to say that he was threatening them with a sawed-off shotgun. When police got here, he came outside. They tell us that he actually had the shotgun in his hand. And at that point, he refused to give up. They say he went back inside, barricaded himself inside the house, put some boards in the windows, and just would not come out. Still no word on exactly what any of his demands were or what he was bothered about, but we do know from police that he was threatening suicide for the better part of 2.5 hours. So again, at 10:30 tonight, they were able to peacefully talk him down, get him into custody, and that shelter-in-place order for neighbors was lifted. But we did speak with the man who lives on this street, who had come here. His wife lives two houses down from where all of this was happening. She called him at work and was just frantic, concerned about what was going on and about this shelter in place order. Here's what he had to say earlier before this ended.
I was at work. My wife called me about 8 o'clock and just was frantic and said, you know, the SWAT team's on our street. There's cops everywhere. So naturally, I let my upper people know and I took off, got here, and I mean, they wouldn't let us get on the street or nothing, and I've been stuck out in the cold, just kind of, thankfully we got cell phones and stuff, you know, we could talk back and forth, but I mean, my kids are down in the basement, they're in a closet, I mean, they're getting scared, obviously.
So again, at this hour, that standoff ended peacefully. The man is in custody, according to police. They also say that they had report that he was running or involved with some sort of a meth lab inside this house. They have still yet to confirm those reports, but they are working on that ongoing investigation right now. We hope to learn his identity at some point here in the near future. Reporting live in Independence tonight, Jackie Canjado, WLWT News 5. All right.